Hey guys, so this is one of the many tutorials that I'll be doing using the Wet n Wild Trio in Silent Treatment. There's so many different looks you can use with this, and today I am using all three of the colors, and you can see the look right here on my eyes. Hopefully you can see the colors and everything. I know the lighting isn't the best right now. I'm just trying to figure out the lighting and everything. So that's what I'm using. And on my cheeks, I have the Hard Candy Blush in Living Doll. So that's what it looks like on my cheeks. I don't know if you can see it. I just apply it with my fingers. And then on my lips, I have a lip balm, which is Nivea Honey and Milk lip balm, and on top of it I have this lip gloss, which is a light pinky, really light pinky with shimmers. It goes on almost like clear. Just any light color will do. This is from Hard Candy, and it is, I don't know what the color is. Anyway, this is what it looks like. So, and also forgot to mention to apply mascara. Obviously, you always remember to apply mascara, curl your lashes, and apply mascara. So, yeah, I'm going to get ahead into the tutorial, and it is a voiceover, but I love doing this voiceover because I can, don't have to be too serious, and I can just do my thing and whatnot. Hopefully, you like it, and yeah, let's get started. Hey guys, so we're just going to use the Silent Treatment Trio from Wet n Wild, and using the bottom lid color. And we're just going to use a sponge of applicator and apply it over to the lid without passing the crease. And yes, I did prime my eyes previous. I forgot to film it. Sorry about that. And it's just a brown base. Or any of your favorite base you like to use or primer to prime your lids is fine. Just packing the color all over the lid. It's a great taupey silver kind of color. La la la. Alright, okay, now I'm using an Essence of Beauty crease brush, the smaller of the two crease brushes. And I'm just using the middle crease color, which is kind of a dark brown black with gold shimmers. And we're just applying it like a cut crease kind of effect. And just follow the way I'm drawing it on my crease. I don't know how to describe that. Just go 3/4 of the way in, and it tapers inwards. And it's more on the outside, it's less on the inner as you go in. And this cut crease is just make it less intense for daytime work. I'm just going to the mall to buy my friend a birthday present, so I don't want it too harsh of a look. So just apply like I did. It looks kind of black on the screen, but it's not really like black. It's dark brown black kind of color. So yeah. Oh, and now I'm just using a crease blending brush. It's from Quo, so any crease blending brush would do. It's actually called a crease shadow brush. But any fluffy brush will do, and just blend out the color so it doesn't look that harsh. Using on a clean brush, by the way. Don't have any product on the blush. Brush, I mean. It's actually kind of fun doing a voiceover. La 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 la, let's see what I'm doing next. Oh, next I just applied that brow bone color, the very top pinky, light pinky color on the trio. And I just use it to blend out the crease color. Using that same color again, and I'm just going to apply it to my highlight, preferably using a different fluffy brush, but I only have that one brush, so I'm just going to use that. I did order one from e.l.f., so it's coming soon. I was just checking to see if the colors are similar. Again, I'm just blending it, my crease. I don't know if I have color on there or not, but just to blend it out to make it less harsh. And yes, I'm trying to match my other eye. Always the eye that I'm doing off camera is always lighter than my on camera one, so I'm trying to match it up. So I'm just doing the same thing to my crease, and then I'm blending it out with a fluffy brush just to make sure my eyes are even. Usually I do both eyes at the same time, so they're pretty even. So I'm just making sure that they're even. Yes, and I'm drinking my morning coffee. I just woke up, so don't mind me. Love coffee. Must have my coffee in the morning. But one cup of coffee. I'm not like one of those people that need to drink like 10 cups of coffee a day. Not that crazy. I'm just making sure here. I'm just checking to see if both eyes are, you know, even. Okay, I'm just aligning my upper lash line with a Laura Intense liner, as I usually do. Sorry if I'm off camera. And this process will take a long time. I think I am off camera. I didn't realize that. But just line your upper lash line. You can use gel liner if you wish, or if you have pencil liner, any liner that you feel comfortable using. I use liquid liner because it stays on all day, because I get smudges in my eyes pretty easily. Oh, now you can actually see kind of how I do it. I do a lot of videos where I align my upper lash line. It's the same technique that I usually do. So if you've seen a lot of my other tutorials, you probably already know. Okay, I think I'm done with my upper lash. Oh, lower lash line. Now I'm using my Annabelle Smudge Liner in Purple Storm. I don't have a black one, but a black or brown one would do. Just lower lash line, or you can line your waterline. But again, I'm off screen. I'm sorry. I'm very bad at filming this kind of stuff, especially in my new setup here in my new room. Again, I'm just drinking coffee. Da 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 da. So yeah, this is basically what the look looks like. I forgot to say goodbye after I did my voiceover, so I thought I'd go on camera again and yeah, show you what everything looks like and say my goodbye. And yeah, so I'll see you all next video. Bye for now.